just getting to know each other, you know, picking up on traits, picking up on habits. You know, I always like to say that if you know the offense as a quarterback, how the offensive coordinator knows it, then you guys are on the same page. So when a play comes in, I know why he calls a play, because of we're thinking the same. So if I can get myself to think the way he can think, then, you know, then it becomes comes clockwork.
Over the past 2 weeks?
Well, just overall the whole season, and I guess even go back in the spring. But what have you learned most about it?
The biggest thing I think I've taken away from him is my practice habits, probably. You know, when I'm warming up, being more serious, how I warm up, you know, taking every throw as a throw that I'll need to make in a game. So, you know, when we go out there and we're warming up, it's not just throwing the ball. It's, you know, having a thought of where I'm putting the ball in an exact spot, taking the right drop. Because you know, how you practice is how you play. So, you know, practice makes permanent, and that's one big lesson that he's done a good job of instilling in me is that the better you practice, the better you'll play. And I mean, it's kind of cliche, and it's kind of like everybody knows that, but, you know, I think that's been the biggest part in the growth in me is how I've practiced, and I've continued to be better at practice and leading guys at practice and not being quiet and stuff.
DeMario, it seemed like from the video that ASU put out, you got a little emotional in the locker room after the game. Was there anything specific about that game that led to your feelings?
You know, it was 6 months since my aunt passing, and then on that same day was my grandma's birthday, so that made me kind of emotional. You know, my aunt was like my second mom, so yeah, I was kind of hurt that she wasn't there, but I knew she was there in spirit. These guys got my back, you know, they knew what was going on and everything, so that's really the only reason why I was emotional. I don't really cry much, but you know, that really got to me.
So was it extra special? Was it extra special to have that type of a performance on that night?
Most definitely, and to get a comeback, you know, W at that. You know, just be able to be in the team and in the locker room, being able to celebrate with my teammates. Not really. You know, I try to keep my mind off it as much as possible, but, you know, my dad ended up calling me. Like, you know, it's been 6 months, stuff like that, so it kind of brought tears to my eyes. And then I was talking to my grandma the whole day that day. You know, and that was her first daughter that passed, so I was kind of hurt, but, you know, I knew my grandma was watching. I knew she was kind of bawling up tears after the game, too, so, you know, it was emotional. Big leap in being a leader of the team, you know, and stepping in my game every week, not just being consistent. Listening to this guy on the side of me. We're just trying to win out in November and see what God has in store for us after the season.
Manny, only two negative plays in that game and no turnovers. I know you had to scramble sometimes, but was that as clean of a performance in those areas as the offense has had, do you think?
Yeah, I think offensive line did a really good job of, tackles did a good job of setting the pocket at the top. Guards were really firm up front. I think I can do a better job of, completing a couple balls here and there. But at the end of the day, we did what we had to do. I think that we're doing a good job of simply just game planning the right way. A couple times, we have some batted balls and stuff like that, which those are nerve-wracking plays, balls in the air. It's almost never good. So, those are some things I can clean up on of, taking a different drop when we're throwing quick game or whatever it is. And it's just all little things that, like I say it every year, you're going to have issues in games. There's not going to be any perfect game. So it's just about correcting those, making sure you don't make those same mistakes again and trying to be flawless as possible.
And you're leading the Pac-12 ASU in fewest turnovers. How much of a point of pride is that for you guys?
I'm just trying to do what I was coached to do, and that's only football. If we're +3 in the turnover margin every game, then that's what we preach is to be that every week. And I'm just trying to do my best job of putting us in the position to win football games.
We feel like if we +3 every week, that's an advantage of winning the game. So we go into the game +3 in the turnover ratio, and it's showing the scoreboard and capitalizing on getting all that.
Mar, last time you played at the Rose Bowl, you had a pretty solid day and a pretty big win for the program. What do you remember kind of about that day playing at the Rose Bowl and getting the big win?
Just another day in the office. Just doing what I'm supposed to do, running hard, blocking, bringing things up for everybody else in the offense. Just another day in the office. I'm going back home. That's 45 minutes from around that, so it's kind of a big game for me. I got a lot of friends on UCLA, SC, so it's going to be it. But, I can't let the emotions get to me, and just let it be another day in the office. Come to work with my hard hat toolbox, and going here in Southern California, it's going to be vital territory. It's going to be loud. They haven't lost the game at home, so they're gonna give us their best game. We gotta come out and just play the way we've been playing and it'll show up on the scoreboard.
So DeMar, when you see what Benjamin did on Saturday, you're probably not surprised. But talk about his development and how much you've been a mentor and a little for him.
My little bro. Like I said, on Saturday he don't got no choice but to fill the big shoes that are leaving after this year. I was kind of nervous at first, because he's a young guy, that's a big game. So it's like, I was kind of nervous. And then I thought about it, like, man, he been watching me this whole year. So it's like, I know he gonna do what he gotta do. And he came out and balled out, and I'm excited. He's building his confidence every week. He coming in ready to play. He's starting to practice like a pro. And he's starting to take care of his body more. He's starting to actually learn like the little things about the game inside and outside of the football, on and off the field. So, I'm gonna continue to help him even when I'm not here. Him and Traylon, when I'm not here, I'm still gonna continue to do my job as a big bro and help them out and make sure they're good, even when I'm not here.
Kalen Thomas had a blocked punt in the fourth, and you guys came on, and that was when Eno was able to capitalize and get that touchdown. What was the feeling when you walked back out onto the field offensively before that drive?
You got the momentum. Those are opportunities to push the momentum and get it rolling, really rolling. And you just gotta go get points. Anytime defense gets any turnover, whether it's they get a turnover on our 1 yard line, we gotta go get points because it's you gotta capitalize on turnovers. Just simply put like that.
I didn't even know the kick was blocked, but once I heard the kick blocked, and I heard the crowd, I was like, oh, the kick just got blocked. And then I'm like, hey, we got to go score right now. We got to go capitalize. He's like, all right, let's go. You know, we ended up capitalizing on that drive, tying the game up. Then Brandon came in with the big onside kick. You know, we tried to get the field goal, but unfortunately, it didn't happen. But it was the best for us, best situation for us. You know, we made the most coming out of halftime.